You were the only fighter on the planet, a star, to give Ronda Rousey encouraging words after her knockout. Why did you do it, and what responses did you get from that?
I tweeted that because I didn't do it for a publicity stunt. Everybody, a lot of people probably thought I did it for a publicity stunt, but I tweeted her, and hopefully it got to her, because I was once that young, rising star on top, you know, and when I took my first loss, I knew how it felt. So I went through it before, and, you know, like I said, it took me 3 years to become champion again. And, you know, I just had to let her know, man, just she'll be back again.
Do people around you change when you lose? Because you're the same.
Ah, man, you know, before the loss, you know, it was 200 calls a day. After the loss, it was maybe 8.
Wow. And what kept you going, not giving up, not saying, you know what?
My children. You know, after the loss, I went home. And I told, well, my son Admire was 3 years old then. No, he wasn't three, he was one. And I told him, I picked him up and I told him that he'd be champion again. It took 3 years, but.
You know one thing about you, Adrien? Everyone that I go to, every gym, people, whether they love you or hate you, they follow you like crazy. Do you sense it too? Even the haters love you?
They love me, man, you know. But it's a love-hate thing, you know. It's okay.
What's the hardest thing about being you, AB?
Waking up in the morning, you know, let's say I had the worst day ever today. I still got to come and put on a smile and shake hands and take pictures.
So when you talk about Ronda Rousey and her first loss, what did you go through? Take us through that. What is the fighter's mindset? How did you get over it finally?
It's different for everybody, but for me, it was like, all right, you know, it had to be God because I did everything right. It's just, you know, I lost the decision. So I'm going to go back to the gym and let the man upstairs make the decision.
Do you want that rematch with Sean?
Of course. Of course. Madonna, of course.
Have you seen Madonna lately? Have you seen some of the pictures and stuff?
I haven't seen him. I heard he's big as Jay-Z lips. But no disrespect to Jay-Z, but you know, but it's okay, man. He's having fun, and I'm happy for him.
Does the sports team mentioning you as an opponent, does that make Ashley being on the 10th?
I would love to fight Ashley Theo Payne because the build up to the fight would be so big. But if Pacquiao wants that me to be his last fight, then of course I will do it.
Maybe when you think about Floyd, would you come back if you were him? Because everybody keeps talking about he's going to come back. And he says,
I mean, you got to understand, that man been on top. He's been boxing for 18 years. What's going on, baby? 18 years. He's been boxing all his life. His hands, you know, I really talk to him. I know his hands is really, really one of the reasons why he's getting out the game. And, you know, he's really tired of the game. You know, he's done.
Did you guys ever share the ring? I know you're not ever going to fight him. Did you ever spar him and get that opportunity to see what it feels like to be in there with him?
It's coming. It's coming because me and him, we talk about it, and he's like, all right, when we do it, everybody got to get out to gym. I mean, like, but we never really made it happen, but I know it's coming soon.
Like in the movie Rocky, when Rocky and Creed get in there.
I never seen the movie Rocky yet, but I know that me and Floyd will be sparring in a ring soon.
How are you going to approach that? Are you going to go hard as hell? Are you going to work? What are you going to do?
I mean, like I always say, you know, maybe I get in there, he kick my ass, and he teach me a lot. Or maybe we get in there and it's neck to neck, and I still learn a lot. Or maybe we get in there and I kick Big Bro's ass, but I still learn a lot. I don't know. You never know how it's going to go. So, you know, one day it will happen, but it haven't happened yet.
They always said you were going to take over after he left. Do you still feel that way, AB? Are you going to be the guy that's going to take over the sport?
Of course. Who's going to do it? Who else can do it?
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.